Prafulla Chandra Ray had his early education in the school founded by his father in Rarudi. In 1870, his family shifted to Calcutta for better educational facilities. There, he got admitted to Hare School. While Prafulla was in fourth standard in 1874, he got a bad attack of dysentery, which caused him to discontinue his studies for about 2 years. Although Ray later remembers this disruption as a blessing in disguise, as it opened doors to a wide range of learning, which was not just limited to the school curricula. However, such a long period of disease impaired his digestive organs, and even after recovery, Ray suffered from residual bouts of indigestion and insomnia for the rest of his life, thus making him a permanent valetudinarian. In 1876, Ray resumed his regular studies at Albert School, Calcutta, which was established by Keshab Chandra Sen, the founder of Bharatvarshiya Brahmo Samaj. Ray had always been a diligent and dedicated student. After clearing the entrance exam in 1879, he took up admission at Metropolitan Institution, now called Vidyasagar College, named after its founder, Pandit Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar. Ray mentions in his autobiography,
"This was the first bold experiment in India of making higher education as cheap as secondary education. In the first place, the Metropolitan Institution was a national institution and something we could look upon as our own."
Metropolitan College had certain great teachers like Prasanna Kumar Lahiri and former President of Indian National Congress, Surendranath Banerjee. These two strongly influenced the nationalist feelings of Ray and inspired him to work towards the upliftment of society. Ray's primary focus was towards literature and history, but chemistry was a compulsory subject in the BA degree he was pursuing. As the Metropolitan Institution had no facilities for science subjects at that time, Ray's physics and chemistry classes were held at the Presidency College as an external student. Chemistry soon became his favorite subject, which was being taught by Professor Alexander Pedler, whose teaching methodology influenced Ray to take up the study of chemistry. Being inquisitive in nature since childhood, he was not merely satisfied by watching the classroom experiments. Ray had set up a mini laboratory at home along with one of his friends and reconducted the experiments taught to them in the college. Halfway through his BA studies in 1882, Ray won the Gilchrist Scholarship of Edinburgh University. Only two students were selected from India, Prafulla Chandra Ray and a Parsi student, Bahadurji. Ray then enrolled as a BSc student at the University of Edinburgh without completing his original degree. He sailed for the United Kingdom in August 1882 at the age of 21 years. He completed his BSc in the year of 1885. At the age of 26 in 1887, he was awarded a DSc in inorganic chemistry for his thesis, Conjugated Sulfates of Copper Magnesium Group, a study of isomorphous mixtures and molecular combination. This was judged as the best thesis and got Hope Prize, which allowed him to carry research for one more year. He was elected as the Vice President of the Edinburgh University Chemical Society in the same year. Before returning to India, Ray was given testimonials and recommendations, which mention highly of his attainments in the field of chemistry. At that time, letters of recommendations were mandatory to get a job under the education system implemented by British. His professors had written impressive letters of introduction, mentioning him to be an invaluable asset to any institution. On his return to India in 1888, he applied for a job at Indian Educational Services, and despite his impressive letters of recommendations, he had to remain jobless for a year. There were two classes in the Education Services, Imperial and Provincial. The Imperial service was mostly reserved for Europeans and had more pay and privileges. Such was the extent of racial discrimination by the British that Ray was appointed as a temporary assistant professor in chemistry under the provincial service with an absurdly low salary of Rs. 250 per month. He went to Darjeeling to talk to British officer Sir Alfred Croft, the director of public instruction, to discuss the injustice being meted out on him. As Ray mentions in his autobiography,
Croft almost got into a temper and exclaimed, "There are other walks of life open to you. Nobody compels you to take this appointment."
Ray protested against this humiliation, but accepted the job due to his passion for research and teaching in July 1889. In 1916, the then Vice Chancellor of Calcutta University, Ashutosh Mukherjee, invited P.C. Ray and C.V. Raman as Pandit professors of chemistry and physics respectively to join the newly opened university, College of Sciences, Rajabazar, Calcutta. The Pandit Chair of Chemistry is a chemistry professorship in the University of Calcutta, which was named after Sir Tarkanath Pandit, who donated Rs. 1.5 million to the university in 1912. Here, Ray was able to carry out his research work along with his students in a much better manner. Ray is credited for shaping the science college into a center of excellence. It was during this time his students started calling him by the title Acharya.